Welcome to Thoughts on Teens in Focus. I'm your host, Patricia Trim, and I'm at the Brooklyn Borough Hall with the Guyana Cultural Association. The Guyana Cultural Association is a cultural program of Guyana, and it is being headed by Claire Goring and other members. So you'll get more from us from the Guyana Cultural Association.
I have broke my trust to the audience, but you will understand why I have to do this. She is new, she is a woman, and she is us.
Thank you very much, Abby, and a pleasant good evening to everyone. First of all, let me apologize for being very, very early, being here on time for the, I was in time for the thank you, the vote of thanks. Nevertheless, my day started very early this morning, and I can see till I'm having a very early evening. But I would like, first of all, to congratulate the persons who received awards this evening, and to congratulate as well the Guyana Cultural Association on their 15th anniversary celebration. I noticed the office gave me a whole program of activities for the Guyana Cultural Association. And I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to complete all of them this weekend, but I'll try nevertheless. But I want to say that through culture and the arts, we manage to maintain unity within the Guyanese community. And I see the work that you have been doing, especially with the young interns, as you mentioned, as a very positive aspect for the future of the Guyanese community. So I want to thank you for the work that you have been doing, and I wish you all the best as you journey on in your endeavors within the Guyana Cultural Association. Thank you.
Everyone. To the Madam Consul General, the Honorable Barbara Atherley, and Borough President a little earlier, but he is a very busy person. I think he's far away from us right now, but he sent someone who's near to us. She is his Chief of Staff, Sylvia Hamer, and Sylvia will now bring us a message on behalf of the Borough President. Sylvia, I invite you to the podium.
Good evening.
Good evening.
All right, much better. You're here to have a good time tonight and celebrate, so we might as well be in an upbeat mood right away. Borough President Adams does send his regrets. He's sorry he could not be here, but he asked me to bring you greetings on his behalf. So I want to welcome you all to Borough Hall, and this is an opportunity for us to join in your celebration as well with you. And we also want to congratulate Dr. Cambridge and the rest of his team for 15 good years, and we expect more from you. And please do come back to the Borough Hall and celebrate with us again. Thank you and have a good evening.
I want to thank Vibert for that very inspiring keynote address. But before I go further into what he said, I have here with us Ms. Michelle Seeley, who wants to present on behalf of Senator Roxanne Passau. She's going to be giving on to Vibert. Come, Ms. Seeley. She's doing a citation for Vibert, which he so very well deserves.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ms. Michelle Seeley. I'm representing New York State Senator Roxanne Jacqueline Passau. She couldn't be here with us tonight because she's in the middle of a very, very busy election year, and she has a challenger, so we have to move. On behalf of Senator Passau, she'd like to present this citation to Dr. Vibert Compton Cambridge. Whereas a great state is only as great as those persons who give exemplary service to their community. The quality of service rendered by Dr. Vibert Compton Cambridge is in direct proportion to his commitment to excellence, embodiment of strength and courage, doing ordinary things extraordinarily well. Thank you so much for your service.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I ask you to give a standing ovation to Guybert, because we didn't do it for his 80, and so we do it now for 20 for the achievement, the Golden Arrow achievement, and for this citation, which says a lot about this humble man, who's our president, Dr. Guybert Compton Cambridge, that we call VC. Thank you, Guybert. Hello, the Honorable Barbara Atherley. And with that, I think we're going to have Jege to lead us on to the reception. And again, thank you for being such a wonderful and patient audience. Having broken protocol, I need to apologize, but I had to do it. I just had to let you see who your new Consul General to New York is. So thanks again. And so we are going to be led to the reception. I would like to get one. I don't know how we're going to do it. But we can see how that happens. Okay, we have the National School of Dance with us from Guyana. And so, National Dance Company, beg your pardon. The National Dance Company. And they came all the way from Guyana to be with us during this period. I know today they were visiting at my church because I serve the higher power as well. I serve God through being a warden at St. Gabriel's Episcopal Church. So I wear many hats. And so I know today that they had a very nice rehearsal at St. Gabriel's. And so we invite to come out now. May we have you, National Dance Company, all the members of the National Dance Company.
To remember, so they won't forget. I
company, and I understand that the other members of the National Dance Company are sitting amidst our audience. Will you please stand? And I ask the Miss Daniel, Vivian, would you please come forward to be recognized? We can't see at the back of our heads, so therefore we would like Vivian has brought the troupe, the dance company, to perform for us. And so, thank you very much, Vivian, and the members of the National Dance Company. And so, we come to the high point of this afternoon, this evening, as we're easing into evening. The high point of our awards, and the most I will do at this point, I will ask our president, Dr. Vibert Cambridge, to come up and to make a worthy presentation about the person we are about to award with the Guyana Cultural Association's Lifetime Achievement Award. Dr. Cambridge, would you come up, please?
On Claire Goring's watch.
Yes.
For 15 years, she has been GCA's cultural director. She brought to it a heritage from Victoria. She's a direct descendant of one of the original purchasers of Plantation Northbrook in 1839 and the creation of the Guyana Village Movement. Her mother was Nenen to Victoria, and is remembered as a church leader, an organizer of the Mothers Union, of Ghana Day celebrations, of planting of maypoles, and art exhibitions, one of which featured the early young Philip Moore. Claire Goring is from a family with a tradition of public service. Her aunt, the late Gwen Paris, Arrow of Achievement, was among the University of Guyana's first graduates. She was the first woman to become a permanent secretary in Guyana. As PS, Minister of Information, she was characterized as a principled leader, and she led that ministry during a very creative period, a period when that ministry had the task of crafting and popularizing the symbols of nationhood and identity. It was into this creative environment that Claire joined after leaving Bishop's High School. The late E.R. Burroughs was one of her teachers. She remembers him fondly as a person who encouraged her creativity. The challenge to develop a float for Guyana's 1970 Republic celebrations represents the start of her career in the festival arts. For more than two decades, Claire Goring was associated with outstanding and innovative costume bands and floats during the annual Mashromani celebrations. The 1,000 person strong band from whence we came is emblematic of her creations. This aspect of her career blossomed in the private sector as the creative producer and director at Needle Chance Solo Organization. With a commitment to Nice Up Guyana, Claire was in the forefront of a very creative period. Let me just say these things before I get mixed up. So with her commitment to Nicing Up Guyana, she was in the forefront of mega shows. Guyana's current comfort with soca is a direct relationship to her tasks. When she brought Boy Blue and Imam Ali Shaw and David Rudder and folks to Guyana. Theme shows, concerts, fashion shows, and conducting training courses for rural school teachers on costume making. Claire has been active in New York for more than two decades also. She has designed and produced costume bands for the West Indian Day Parade on Labor Day. She has shared her knowledge and experience and treasure the GCA. And as Ave pointed out, earlier this year, she piloted the creation of the Guyana Arts and Cultural Center. Claire Goring does not look for accolades. She has a largeness of spirit, the ability to see task and service above self. Her leadership over the past 15 years has been exemplified by a style that attracts and encourages participation. She has a personality that integrates. She is what we call an integrating personality. Her body of work represents and exemplifies the core values that GCA privileges when making awards. As you mentioned earlier, originality, scope, impact and influence, contribution to harmony, innovation, and creative responses to challenges. Today, join us as we bestow upon Claire, in this golden jubilee year, our highest award, the Lifetime Achievement Award. Congratulations.
The Lifetime Achievement Honoree. Claire wears many hats. Aside from being the mother to many, she is a true friend, a confidant, and the most important role of all, a talented cultural icon of Guyana. She is culturally sound as a playwright, grant writer, cultural director, and costume designer who is knowledgeable in the various art forms. Claire's exposure to the arts began as a student of Bishop's High School in Guyana, and then later illuminated when she joined the family of Solo, headed by Mr. Neil Chan, to whom she is forever grateful. At Solo, Claire's artistic talents really came to fruition as she was able to bring them alive in forums that represented theatrical productions. To her credit, she has done these productions internationally. There is so much to be said about this daughter of Guyana soil, with not enough time to do so. When one thinks of Guyanese culture in New York, or even in the United States, Claire Ann, Miss Goring, all the same person comes to mind. This entrepreneur is one of the earliest Guyanese designers to have Guyana represented on Eastern Parkway, Brooklyn, in the West Indian Day Carnival. To her credit, for decades, she has had a vision of Guyanese having their own arts and cultural center here in New York. Proudly as the cultural director of Guyana Cultural Association and its board sharing this vision, the Guyana Arts and Cultural Center was recently launched in January of this year. Claire's expertise as a graphic artist is exemplified in many souvenir journals, brochures, birthday, anniversary, and funeral programs. How about her one-of-a-kind handmade postcards with every conceivable detail present depending on the occasion? She makes Guyana proud because she is internationally known as other nationalities seek out her expertise here in the United States and from abroad. As the Guyana Cultural Association celebrates this significant milestone, its 50th anniversary, Claire's instrumental role is to be applauded, as for many years, the Secretariat has had many meanings. She's considered the heartbeat of what we do. This selfless community leader is contented with directing in the background while professionalism unfolds during cultural productions. These few words do not do justice to Claire Ann Goring, but gives a glimpse of the very important individual who we honor today with the Lifetime Achievement Award. Claire Ann Goring, we the members of Guyana Cultural Association say thank you, especially today, by honoring you. Congratulations as we embrace you with hugs and kisses. From your loving, GCA family.
Could we please also ask the members of the awards committee to step forward, because we want to have
president and executive members of the GCA, sponsors, supporters, and friends. Today, I express sincere appreciation and thanks to the Guyana Cultural Association of New York and Awards Committee for recognizing me with the Guyana Cultural Association's Lifetime Achievement Award. I also express the same sentiments on behalf of Mr. Cyril Dabedin and Mr. Cyril Bryan, who both received the Exemplary Award and also our esteemed group of 2016 awardees. A good friend once told me when I said I was uncomfortable receiving awards, "Hey, not just about you, you know." That person was Godfrey Chin.
Yes.
Godfrey, I understand that now. I'm truly humbled and honored to receive this award. But as I receive this award, I recognize that today's achievement is due to the support and encouragement of many. I could not do it alone. I did not do it alone. I am a living example of the village that raised a child. And so I give thanks to my mother, Vera Goring, who showed me by example how important it was to use your talent to give back to your community. My aunt, my niece Alicia, who is my backbone, my nephews Osan and Dwight, my cousins Faye, Claire, Carol, and Eula. The village of Victoria, where my pride as a woman of African descent was nurtured and given opportunity to grow. And my GCA family, without whom I would not be standing here today. I would like to congratulate the members of the GCA, many of whom I've known and worked with for more than 30 years. Morris Blenman, who was my right hand, and Gareth Matty, even in the days of costume making and international productions. Rose October Eden, Verna Walcott, Margaret Lawrence, Malcolm Hall, and former member Desiree Etchell and Tandri, members Desiree Etchell and Tandri Clark, who were part of the many long nights in the solo mash camp preparing for one of the productions over the years. Our president, Barbara Cambridge, who conceptualized the idea of a day devoted to celebrating our folk heritage and of nicing up Guyana. Alfred Brewster Haynes, who was a relative I could go to for advice. To the other members who I'm fortunate to be able to call friend and who are not only supportive of my work, but more so of the mission of GCA. Negra Brandis, Juliet Emanuel, Claire Patterson Mona, Ashton Franklin, Pat Jordan Lanford, Ron Lamy, and all of the other members. As the Guyana Cultural Association continues on its 15-year journey, and as we mark 13th annual GCA Awards, I want to wish you continued success. I look forward to playing an integral role in our mission to document, showcase, and celebrate the multiple roots of Guyana's cultural heritage. May God bless us all in this journey. And I'd like the audience to join me in a round of applause for GCA.
Could we get all the awardees up, please? All the awardees. And do showcase your Oscars. I want also to point out, while we are gathering, is Ashton here? Ashton is a member of our group, and he's very creative. He had to do with this whole designing, he originally did the designing of our stick. And so it takes so many of us to bring to fruition these things that you see, and they may look simple, but the thought process is very deep. So this is Ashton, while we await all the awardees. And he worked with Jonathan and Claire and everybody else to bring about these Stickman Oscars. I like that name, Stickman Oscars.
Thank you.
I think we're going to have Jege to lead us on to the reception. And again, thank you for being such a wonderful and patient audience. Having broken protocol, I need to apologize, but I had to do it. I just had to let you see where your new Consul General to New York is. So thanks again. And so we are going to be led to the reception by our great trio. Come on down, boys. Let's have it.